This song is dedicated to the very underrated and nonsensical 16-bar blues. I wrote this when I was 18. Just moved down to go to school in the mountains. And I thought I was pretty cool because I was writing a blues song. I didn't really know what to do. I didn't know what to write. I had writer's block, and I thought, well, if you have writer's block, you write a blues song because you don't really have to do much, you know. So I said, well, I'm going to be cool, and I'm going to add another bar to it. I'm going to add another four bars to it. I'm going to add a fourth line, you know, instead of the normal line. Third line, he goes, and I thought, well, I'm going to add another one, you know? Just when you think it's going back to the first thing, it's like, oh, look at that. So that's what I did, and I made it into this song called the Louisiana Blues, which went through a number of rewrites. You'll be shocked to hear once you hear the song. And I ended up, there's an old jazz singer, blues jazz singer named Mose Allison, who was one of my biggest influences, who I've loved for forever. And I was listening to him a lot at this time, and I'd actually just seen him play in New Orleans, and he was about 82 years old then. And I really wanted to intersperse one of his songs into this, so I did. In the middle of it, you'll hear it. It's called Louisiana Blues. The seventh son.
Oh, 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 oh Mm-hmm.